Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to see the World Television Championship on the line here in just a few moments. Now, just a few moments ago, we heard Nature Boy Ric Flair make a statement that he would have a major announcement here next week on the program, and also that he would be wrestling. I'm sure that that announcement is going to concern the world's heavyweight champion, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Steamboat is now in Japan defending the NWA Championship, but before he left the States, he had this to say to the fans of the NWA.
I think when people think of Ric Flair and people think of Ricky Steamboat, they're looking at two gladiators, two men that respect the business, the profession of wrestling, two men that have the same purpose in mind when they climb into the ring. Out of the ring, we are two totally different types of guys, two totally different types of lifestyles. Me being more with the family unit, believing in my wife and my son, and Flair, the flamboyant one, and loves to have his entourage with him, his women at his side, his Lear jets, his limousines, and the fur coats. But the bottom line is that we both respect this business, and that this business is, after all, professional wrestling. And we both have one thing in mind, and that is to be a world champion. He's been at it for, I guess, four or five times have been the NWA champion, and this being my first. Well, I think, Ric Flair, that you became mentally tired and that maybe you let your guard down in Chicago. I'm being a little bit younger and a little bit more hungrier because going after this title for the first time and trying to win it from you. But I also understand now, and the word is out, that you're after me and that you're not going to let anyone that believes in the beliefs that I have and the background that I have hold on to something like this. You want me to be the shortest reign champion ever. Now, I can understand that coming from you because you do a lot of talking. And although I try to take care of my business in the ring, I will meet you at any time, any place, any city. You name the location, you name the time. Make it Christmas Day, Thanksgiving, or your birthday. I'll be there.
This event will be for the World Television Championship. Impressive young Bob Emery, who's put together quite a string of victories in the last few weeks in some of the major arenas around the country, having his opportunity here. Mike, that's what hard work and perseverance will do for you. And the kids, the little kids that are competing in perhaps wrestling now, the playoffs and the tournaments, never give up, because Bob Emery has never given up, and he's earned his right to go for the television championship against Mike Rotunda.
Well, all those hard hours in the gym, all those hours laboring, the sweat, the pain, the aggravation, it all has a chance to pay off here, and Bob Emery's got the chance of a lifetime. World television title on the line.
Side headlock by Mike Rotunda, taking Bob Emery over, and the entire roster of the Varsity Club with Dr. Death, Dan Spivey, and, of course, the Games Master, Kevin Sullivan. Does his cranium look like it's swelling up again? He may have to go back in for more tests.
Well, I don't know exactly how secure they can feel in having this world title, because it wasn't exactly a grandiose manner in which he won that title from Rick Steiner.
Of course, to hear them tell it, that they would have a different version of that. We'll be talking to Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Rick Steiner, and Missy Hyatt a little bit later in the program. Bob Emery, nice wrist lock, but Rotunda, as soon as I could say that, recounted it right into a hammer lock. Rotunda grabs the hair of Bob Emery, sends him to the ropes, and he's like a bully that you used to see, the slamming locker door shut and taking people's lunch money.
Jim, he's not happy just to out-wrestle you. He wants to intimidate you as well, and Bob Emery's a big kid, but, he's up against the whole Varsity Club here, not just Mike Rotunda.
Well, they had a little huddle there, talk over some strategy. Quite an array of talent here. Of course, Rotunda from Syracuse, Spivey from Georgia, Dr. Death from Oklahoma, Kevin Sullivan from the University of Mars. And Rotunda with that European-style forearm. Well, I'll tell you what, that was made famous by a great NWA World Champion, Dory Funk Jr., and Rotunda can execute it extremely well. Nice side headlock by Bob Emery. And Emery's got to try to control as much of the offense as he can.
Well, this is where experience comes into play, because Rotunda's been the champ before. He held it for a long time, and he knows what it takes to defend the championship. It's a lot different going after it and then defending against anybody coming after you. And Bob Emery's in for a real test here tonight.
We want to say hello to all the great fans in the Sunshine State of Florida, the NWA tonight in Jacksonville. And, of course, we look forward to being in Shreveport tomorrow night with our camera going right inside the huddle. They weren't too pleased with that particular camera shot. Great shot, though, taking us right into the huddle. I do want to mention, fans, that tomorrow night in Shreveport, this Tuesday night in Baton Rouge, this Wednesday night the NWA will be in New Orleans at the Downtown Municipal Auditorium, Thursday night in Pensacola, Florida, and Friday night in Greenville, South Carolina. So a lot of big NWA action in the next few days across this great land of ours. And fans, we do want you to stay tuned, and we'll tell you how you can get your official NWA Old Spice gym bag. So get your pencil and paper handy for that information. Scoop slam. You know one thing about Rotunda? He is such a great counter wrestler.